Where were you the day you found out Michael Hutchins died?
I was in Barrel in New South Wales. I was living in Melbourne, but I'd come up to visit my kids on a weekend, and it was like a Saturday morning. And I remember Michael Chugg rung my mobile phone and said, "Listen, don't alarm you, but there's a body in the room." And I just go, "Body? Room?" I said, "Which room?" He said, "At the Ritz-Carlton in Double Bay." And I knew INXS was staying in there, and I sort of, "You're kidding me?" And he didn't sort of, he said, "Yes. And we don't know, nothing's confirmed yet, but just wanted to let you know." And this is Chuggy calling me. Then like 5 minutes later, another phone goes off. It's Michael Gadinsky on the phone to me. He says, "Mate, do not switch your phone off after this call and don't answer any phone calls for 2 days. I said, "What's going on?" He said, "Michael's dead. He's definitely dead. You know, the police are going, everything's happening. This is like 9:30 in the morning. It's all happening." And it was in, you know, can imagine it shook Australia to the core. Can you imagine what it did to people who knew him, you know, like, I remember the times I've had with Michael, you know, without drinking beers in Italy, without backs against the wall, you know, laughing our heads off and him not hating the rest of the band, but we're still laughing to be with him and Chris Bailey from the Saints and me in Paris, just the three of us drinking Courvoisier and getting shit-faced on brandy and cognac up at he and Elena's flat and, you know, then going off to dinner somewhere and talking about anything but music. I remember Michael saying to me, you know, this discussion one night that went with Chris Bailey, who's a fantastic erudite man, you know, just a great guy to talk to. It's Chris Bailey from the Saints I'm talking about. And Michael said, "You know what I hate?" And I said, "What's that? What do you hate?" He says, "I hate being Michael Hutchins." "What do you mean?" He says, "Well, what I love is being in Paris with Helena. I love being able to stroll down and get eggs on a Sunday morning and then go and wander through bookshops and doing stuff. What I hate is being Michael Hutchins, where I have to put on my charisma coat." And they're very clear words, you know, his coat of charisma, and play Michael Hutchins, the pop star, and go out and do that. And that sort of gives you some indication what he was really like. Because he comes, you know, like me, come from a broken family, you know, like me, he was looking at a dream. You know, we identified, I guess, on a lot of different things. And it was someone that I'd been there at the start of their career, went through their career with them. Even when we did albums like The Swing, they would still come back to me and say, "Can you listen to this?" But they booked the studio for a day or two just for me to listen to it and say, "Yeah, this is okay." And not so much with Kick and X by that stage, but because they were just too big and too famous at that time when that was going on. But yeah, we always kept in contact, you know, and the rest of the band and I do to this day, and to the point where it's pretty much I'm the only person allowed to touch the music. And it's still, we do that, you know. Like last year I remixed 10 INXS albums, all of Michael's ones, for use to how we're going to use them. We didn't mix them in stereo, we mixed them in what we call in stems, so they can be used for different sorts of movies and bits and pieces, but pretty much. And so, like, you can imagine, in November was 20th, when I was in the studio and I had remixing, and I had Michael talking to me on the anniversary of his death, you know, and it was very poignant, I got to tell you, you know, to listen to, because I had I could listen to anything by itself, and I had to listen to Michael because of what we were doing, you know, we were mixing this stuff. But not only was I listening to the words that he was saying, I was listening to what he was listening to saying between the tracks and comments, before a take, throwing a joke at Johnny, or, you know, telling Andrew this is that, and et cetera. So it's quite an effect that had on me, and the effect it had on Australia was massive at the time, and the effect it had on the world, it was incredible.